Hey guys, Wells Knight here, and welcome back to another episode of Kingdoms. And we have enough iron to make ourselves a full beacon, which means it is time to use our three wither skeleton skulls and kill ourselves a wither. I think we are long overdue for that. We've been sitting on the wither skeleton skulls for a while now, and I think I'm pretty much as prepared as I need to be. I've got full diamond armor, I've got strength 2, regeneration, smite 5, axe, which I almost didn't bring with me. That would have been horrible. Let's try this again. Let's just go grab our axe. I think I'm actually going to put my sword into my ender chest, because I don't really need it. I do, however, need my battle axe that has smite 5. Should make... between this and strength 2, I should be able to bring down this wither pretty easily. So, we're just gonna come down here, and I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go down one of these tunnels quite a ways. And once we've gone down here a bit, this'll probably work right here, actually. This little section. This should do. Let's just go ahead and do that, and then we'll just take the top off there. Of course I would misplace that, naturally. Let's eat a little bit of food, and away we go. Run away. All right, he's gonna explode anytime with her. There we go. All right, so we will shoot him with the bow until... Oh, he's going the wrong direction. That's not the way I wanted him to go. I probably could have done this better. Oh, now he sees me. Yeah, now he's mad. There we go. All right, come at me, wither. There, now he is invulnerable to arrows, so let's pop our strength potion, drink our regeneration potion, and hey, come back. And we'll just... Wow, that's what I call some damage. That axe... Got him. There... Oh, please tell me the Wither Star didn't fall into the lava? Or the Nether Star? Oh, it didn't. Okay. Was really worried there for a sec. That would have been... Really... That would have been depressing. Let's be honest. That would have been just straight up depressing. If I had lost the Nether Star... after killing the Wither. But we killed the Wither, and now we have ourselves a Nether Star, which means we can go ahead and make ourselves a full-on beacon, which is going to mean getting cobblestone and smooth stone and pretty much everything else that you can mine in vast quantities. It's going to be super easy. So, very good about that. I also done some stuff in our farming village, which I still haven't picked the name for. You guys have had so many suggestions, and I really just need to take time and look back through them all at this point. And I need to just choose one. We need to pick a name for this farming village. But I've done some work there as far as animal pens. One of you left a comment and said, hey, I asked last episode for some ideas as far as the animal pens, and one of you linked a video by Grian, who I'm sure some of you know who he is at least. He's another YouTuber. Does a lot of building tutorials and stuff like that. And one of you linked that video, a video that he did on animal pens, and I was like, oh, there we go, that's perfect. So I used a design that's very similar to one that he had in that video. It's not exactly the same, but it's really close. And I will, if I remember, I will link the video in the description. But I decided to do that for the animal pens, and we have all the animal pens set up now in our farming village. With the exception of chickens. So let me get some stuff put away and get organized and get my beacon all made up, and I'll come back to you in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back, and you can kind of see the animal pens coming into view right over here. So we got our cows, our sheep, and our pigs all kind of laid out. Here's our cow farm, or our cow pen. We've got our pigs in the middle, and it's a bit smaller because I really don't have any use for pigs whatsoever. And then we've got our sheep over here. So I did that between episodes. In today's episode, what I'd like to do, is I'd like to start working a little bit on a barn, I think. I've been doing some work in a creative testing world, kind of trying to come up with a design that I like, and I think I finally figured something out that I think looks really cool. So we're going to go with that, and it's kind of going to be in the same Tudor style, almost. It's almost going to be like a Tudor barn, which is, but I think you guys will like it, and I think it's going to look pretty cool once it's all said and done. So, I think we're going to put it about here-ish. I think this is a good spot for it. So let me get some land cleared. Let me get some of the foundational stuff kind of laid out and figured out, and I'll be back shortly. All right, guys, I am back. So I think I've got this thing laid out as far as the foundation goes anyway. So what we've got here is we've got a 3-wide entrance here, and then this actually comes up a little bit, and this is where the main level of the barn is actually going to be. And I think it's actually going to create kind of a cool, interesting effect. So let's maybe do something like that. And then here, we're also going to kind of recess these a little bit. That'll be our doorway. And then we need to figure out some of these logs. So we'll go up here and bring that over. And then this guy will need to go up probably, let's see here. If I convert those into planks, let's just put some planks down here and figure out. Yeah, this is gonna have to go up one more, I think. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, there we go. And then this will come over like so. Oh, I'm falling. one second here. Let's just make a little cheap, a poor man's staircase, if you will. Okay, so that's good. And then over here, we would do, did I miscount this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I totally miscounted that. Okay. Well, easy fix. Not a big deal. This is supposed to be 7. There we go. I was gonna say, that doesn't look right to me. And then that guy goes there. And this goes like so. Beautiful. Much better. Okay. And then this come all the way up there. And then we'd have right here more bone blocks like that. That looks good. Okay. And it's getting late, so we should probably go and take a little bit of a sleep. And then we'll start sorting out some of this other stuff. So, there we go. Alright, now this looks a little weird right now. I know. I'm fully aware. Don't worry. It'll be fine. Right here, I think. Actually, right here, we're gonna go like that, and then we'll bring this across, and let's maybe go like this, and then our staircase will come up here. Do I have any oak stairs? I probably do. I'm pretty sure. Let's just take a peek. There we go. Okay, so we'll get our stairs in there, and we're going to want right here, I think, like so. Yeah, so there's our little staircase that leads up and gives you access to this part of the floor, and this will be like the main barn storage area. I don't know if it's going to go down or not, but we'll see. We'll figure that out as we go. Okay, then right here, maybe we'll... Actually, let's do this. There we go. So we'll do that. And then this will come up. And this is going to be a relatively narrow little staircase type thing. Or area, I suppose I should say. And that'll come around. Okay, I think that's a pretty good start. Now we need to work on this main tower part. And we're going to go up pretty high with this. 6, 7, 8 maybe? Let's just see how that looks size-wise. Yeah, that looks about right. That looks to be about right. I think we're going to raise this up higher. Because I think it'll look better if we do that. And let's break that because it looks a little out of place. That's better. Oh, and this one got placed incorrectly too. Fixed. There we go. And then we'll have a tower and a window there. Okay, cool. So now we need to start kind of working out our roof. And I think today we're mostly just going to work kind of on the front facade. And then we'll worry about the rest of it later. That's kind of the plan, at least. So I'm going to need a fair amount of stairs and a lot of planks. I hope that will be enough. I think it will be. I think it will be. There's only really one way to find out. So, yeah, it's fine. Okay, so let's go and put down these. Can I walk out here? I cannot make that. Okay, that's fine. Break that. And we'll just do it from here. That's kind of hard to place, actually. There's one. And I guess this one we'll just pillar up for. There we go. And then let's kick that out to the side a little bit. And then, right here, we're going to want to kick that out as well. And, oh, I don't think I can reach that one either. There we go. Better. And then we need to make sure that that lines up with this guy. So, here. Is that right? Yes. Yes, it is. Okay, good. And I think I may have brought those pillars up a bit too high. We'll have to tweak those a little bit, but that's okay. That's perfectly fine. All right, so that looks good, and that will come to a center point in the middle, which is what we want. Let's just kind of build up behind, like this. Yeah, I definitely brought those up way too high. Well, maybe not. Maybe that is exactly where they were supposed to go, because we're going 1, 2, 3, and like that. And then bring them over. And 1, 2, and up, and over, and then like so. All right. Let's see if that's about the height we want. I think it will be. How's that look? That looks good. That looks like what I want. Awesome. This may need to change, which would not be the end of the world. I think that log is too high, but we'll deal with that. Now we do, before we can, I know I said we're going to focus primarily on the front today, but before we can really nail this down, we also need to work out the roof over here too, and going this direction, because if we don't, the building's going to end up being a really weird shape, and we don't want to deal with that. So let's see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tall, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and that should now be the same height. Let's kick that out and over. And then I think we're going to go... It needs to ultimately be as tall as this. So we're going to go 1, 2 over. Up 1 and over. And then over again. And that might be the height right there. That might be. Let's see. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, man, I can't see it. So from here, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, essentially. 7.5, I guess. And here we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we're close. So we said 2, 1, like this, and over, like that, and over, and then here. See how that looks for a roof shape? That looks good. That's very barn-like, which is what I want. And I believe it's the same height. Yep, looks to be the same height to me. Awesome. Okay, so now that we've got the roof kind of laid out, now we can go back to kind of worrying about the front and the way the front looks again. So let's make a couple spruce fences if we don't already have some. Let's see about maybe doing that. I've got oak fences, but not spruce. Okay, so let's make a few spruce. I don't need tons of them. I just want a couple. Let's do that. And I believe it's that. Oh, that was gates. Oh, that was not what I wanted to do. Windows wheel? Why are you spinning? That was weird. It was very weird. I don't know what was going on there. My thing is possessed, apparently. I don't know. Either way, there we go. Now we got a bunch of spruce fences. And I'm thinking we're going to put spruce fences kind of along here. And then coming over like this, right? So you get kind of this effect where there's a little staircase and you kind of work up. And then this is the main, like, barn area or whatever. This whole thing can go because it's not going to be there. So let's just do away with all of that. And now we need to sort out some of this stuff. So let's go and lay down a little bit of a floor here. Like this. And then we're going to go 1, 2, 3. And turn those up. Oh. And 1, 2, 3. Oh, cool. It ended up in the right spot. Awesome. And that's kind of our barn door right there, which I think looks good. And then here, that I don't like so much. Maybe there we throw in... What would fence gates look like here? I don't think I would like them. Let's do maybe something like that. Just kind of holding up that area and just kind of framing it out a little bit. And it's getting light, so let's take a sleep. And let me get some more work done on the house. I'll be back shortly. All right, guys, I am back, and we've got the main roof half done. We've got half of the roof done here, and I think it looks really good. I think it turned out pretty well. I'm not entirely sold on this little chunk right here. But at the same time, I'm not entirely sure how I would change that, because I do want the look of the pillar going up. Maybe what we'll do is this. Let's try getting up here. And we'll basically just go with the flow. And instead of capping that off with a stair, maybe we just bring the log up. Like that. That was a poor life choice. Can we see how that looks? That's not bad. That's not bad. I think we'll go with that. I think that looks a little bit better than what we had before. So let's just go ahead and kind of bring this whole thing down. There we go. Okay. So that looks good. I need to kind of patch up this side for sure. And we need to figure out what we're going to do here on this side too. So let's go. Let's do this. We'll just bring our bone blocks up until, there we go, that's better. And then we know that this is going to be part of the roof. So we'll just go ahead and do that. And then we know that this is going to be part of the roof, so we'll just go ahead and do that as well. And there we go. Okay, so that's all patched up now. And then we just need to see how that looks from the front. Oh, I forgot to bring that log up. Oh, I knew I was forgetting something. That's okay. We can fix that. We can fix that. Let's just do one of these guys. There we go. And we know that this whole thing is going to be planks. And then we can just take our logs up. Like so. I think that's... I'm 99% sure that's the right height. We'll know in a second, I guess. Let's see. Is that correct? Height-wise, yes. Yes. It looks... I don't love it as much as I thought I was going to be honest. Let's try something different then, I guess. Let's give this a try. If we come to here and we break this out, there we go. What if we do this instead? And we go bump, bump, bump. And then right here, just so we break up this transition, we did something like that instead. That might look a little better. Only one way to find out. Let's break that as well. There we go. Let's see if we can mimic that on this side. I think that's good. And then it was right... Okay, so this guy here is supposed to still be a log. And then we brought that down from over here. Then try breaking out that. Put a stair and like that. Let's see how that looks. Don't like that either. I like the way the roof looks better. I don't like this inner little bit though. It's not doing it for me. Let me see what I can get sorted out. Alright, I am back, and I'm not in love with this hard transition that we have going here, but at the same time, I don't entirely hate it either. I think it could be worse. Maybe what we can do, I do see one change that I do definitely want to make, though, and that is to get rid of this and then extend that up a little bit so it's a little bit more centered, like so. There we go. Alright, so we do something like that. I gotta figure out what the best way to do this is. This is where... Ooh, actually... What if we just did this? That might do what I need it to do. Like that? Because that covers up that nasty transition. Oh yeah, there's our answer right there. That will do. That does what I need it to do. Awesome. So, let's take a little sleep and let's take one more look at it in the daylight. Just make sure we're good with it. I think I'm good with it. I think that's... Yeah, I think of all the solutions, that's probably the best one. Although I'm kind of thinking I want that brought down. Let's make some more trapdoors. And just do something like this. I'm thinking that's how I want it. Just because I think that'll look better. Yeah. Yeah, that looks pretty good. That looks pretty good. I'm quite satisfied with that. All right, let's throw a door on it. We'll just go with a regular old spruce door, and I'll just put that right here. And then maybe here we'll put an oak stair. No, not the oak stair. Don't really love the oak stair. Maybe we just leave it like that. I think that's probably okay. I mean, all in all, I think that's a really good start. And you can get kind of a feel for how it's going to look, even though, I mean, this obviously is not a complete build since, you know, we're missing half the walls and stuff like that, but you can get a feel for it. And that's the big thing, is I just want you to be able to kind of get an idea of how it's going to feel once we get a lot more of this stuff in. And we're also going to need, I think right here, I'll do bone blocks underneath like that. Yeah. And we'll probably break that up again, like right in here, do some of these kind of Tudor-style lines on it up there. But all in all, I think this is a really cool start to a very kind of unique and interesting barn. So, guys, that is going to do it for me for this episode. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.